Hey, it's Philip here, the Curly Marketer, and today I'm asking the question, does your business still need to use email marketing? Stay tuned, I'm going to give you my opinion. Hey, it's Philip here, the Curly Marketer. Today's Curly Marketer tip, we are talking about email marketing and is it still relevant for business? Does your business need to use email? And to give you my opinion, I absolutely think you should. Let's consider this. Statista did some research and they have kind of come to the conclusion that in the year 2022, there's going to be over 3 billion email accounts in use, and there's going to be potentially 333 billion emails sent daily. It's massive. Email is on the rise, you know, much to what everyone's saying that email is dying, that it's going to go away. The research is pointing to the fact that this is not the case. You know, the DMA did some research recently where they discovered that for every pound that you spent on email, you'd get a return on investment of approximately a little over £32. So from a return on investment point, the stats are pointing that email is still very much a potent communication tool. Now, of course, you have to take all of these stats with a grain of salt or with a taste of realism. You know, it's not going to be the same for every business. I think you have to apply a very strategic way of applying email to your own business, because I think what happened was, you know, email at its peak, we suddenly started seeing where everyone was literally getting maybe 20, 30, 40 emails a day, and we all became bombarded. And I think that sort of bad use by companies turned people off, and suddenly email was seen as this like this dirty channel. But I think there's a huge relevance for businesses, and I think if you're not looking at email or you're completely disregarding it, I think you're making a mistake. You know, I think let's consider a couple of things. While I love social media, I think the digital channels and the advances that are happening across social media are very exciting. Let's not forget, if you were building your audience exclusively on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, remember what has happened as we saw with Facebook. You know, maybe 5 years ago, your organic posts were going to be seen by your followers. Now in 2018, it chances that your organic posts are going to be seen by your followers is practically zero, unless you're paying for targeted advertising. And that is the problem when you invest all of your efforts in building an audience exclusively on digital. You're at the mercy of those channels in the hope that they will allow you be able to reach those customers. Whereas by having your own email list of people who have opted in and subscribed and raised their hand to say that they're interested in what you have to say, you have that direct contact. Now, obviously with email, be very, very mindful that you are transparent, that you're trustworthy in how you capture the data, that the people that are subscribing to your emails are very, very understanding as to how you're going to use their data from a data protection point, and always be GDPR compliant, have that in the back of your head. But I wanted to really, you know, give you some benefits as to why you should consider email marketing and try and see how best you can fit it into your business. I think the first thing is it allows you in a very easy and direct way keep in contact with your customers and your prospects. You know, if you've got a permissioned list of people that have raised their hand or said they're interested in what you have to say, it's great to be able to send out an email, whether it's once a month or once a quarter or whatever it might be, that's reasonable, to keep them up to speed on maybe your wins or new products that you've developed or something that you feel could have a real relevance and be of tangible interest to them. You know, so once again, it's that ability to be able to stay in contact with these people personally. I think the second thing that's great is it is very cost effective. I use MailChimp, for example, you know, as a solopreneur, if you want to call it, or a small business. Cost is always at the forefront for me. And I'm able to, for 2,000 email subscribers, send 12,000 emails for free, you know, and then as I tier up on that plan, once again, it's very affordable. So it is not costly to get yourself started on email marketing. I think another great thing as well is that it is measurable. You know, all of the email platforms have fantastic metrics to track bounce rates, delivery rates, open rates, And if you apply then some UTM link tracking with various links within your email, you can start to then see what emails are working, what are not working, etc., etc. So once again, to measure is to know, and this is where this whole question about return on investment comes into play. And with email, you have that real rubber stamp as to what email is working and what is not. I think as well, you can be very personalized and targeted with your emails. For example, as people come to your site, they're going to be at various stages potentially of your sales funnel. Someone who might is just doing research at the moment might download some frequently asked questions or maybe some initial introductory type of ebook or document. Now that person might go into a different email chain where you're just giving them maybe more information, maybe some demo email type content, but then there might be someone else who is further down the line and is showing from, say, requesting quotes, etc., whatever it might be, and you can put them into an email funnel where you're offering maybe a free 14-day trial, whatever it might be. But you're able to segment up your email list to make every contact with those customers as highly relevant and targeted, as personal as you can be. And I think another thing to be very mindful of is that we are living in a mobile world. You know, on research that I've come across here is that 59% of emails are now opened on mobile. So put it this way, you know, you can have an email campaign going out and someone could literally be either in their work environment or walking down the street, or maybe they're on the bus or whatever it might be, and they can open an email and suddenly start to engage with you. So that you have the real flexibility and variety. So that is my view. I think for this first video in relation to email, I think it is definitely, it's a communication channel that a lot of people have sort of ignored or have felt it's not as cool or as sexy as digital, but it has so many advantages. And I think the way digital is going is, I think people need to suddenly now get back into a mind frame where they need to grow their community within their own channels, as in on their website and getting an email list, as opposed to just hoping that the digital channels are going to allow them to communicate with their audience whatever way they want to be. If you're watching me here on YouTube, I hope you enjoyed the video. Do subscribe, and you know, if you have any comments or any other tips or your own views in email, do let me know in the comments below. If you're watching me here on LinkedIn, I'd love to hear from you. Tell me your comments as well, and please do send me a connection request if we are not connected. And I'm over there on Twitter at Pete Twyford. And as always, my website is thecurlymarketer.com, where you can read a full email post that goes with this video. And I'll see you again soon for another Curly Marketer tip. Take care.